what were the principles of effective communication?
Ma'am, there are 7 points which we have to keep in our mind before communicating with others. Like, think before speaking, listen well. Don't hear only, try to listen properly. Your body language should be good. Actions speak louder than words. If you're silent also, then also try to make a posture like that. It feel like you are communicating in well manner. Respect for others. Try to respect others' culture, other tradition. If someone is communicating something, try to respect that. Own the mistake. Try always to apologize if there is your any mistake. And the 7th point is positive attitude. Always try to show your positive attitude towards others.
Can you talk about the quote which was given in the text? First quote, it can be any quote which was given on effective communication. Pick up any thread and start talking.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, apologizing is wonderful art, practice it. There was a quote, apologizing is wonderful art, practice it. If you had done any mistake, if you are mistaken something, always try to apologize, say sorry for it, feel sorry for it. Because that's wonderful.
So make a presentation on apologizing is a wonderful art. Practice it. Make a presentation, make a 2-minute speech on this. Yes, Dosha.
Ma'am, can you give me 5 minutes for thinking?
Yeah, of course. Is anybody else? Pick up the thread from here. Komal Kumari?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, please speak about any quote which you think you want to speak about. The quotes which were given to you. Yeah, firstly, what are the seven golden rules of communication? Yes, Komal?
Yes, ma'am.
What do you think is very important? There is on your camera and there should be no noise. Mute yourself.
Ma'am, first one is articulation of how to think before you speak.
Okay, the first
such one, a way.
Okay, what do you mean by this articulating the thoughts? So,
I mean,
what does it
in a smart way? Yes, ma'am, a smart person know what to say, ma'am. In a smart way, you solve the.
Why is it important for you to think before you speak?
Yes, ma'am.
Tab aage.
Mute yourself, guys. And switch on your cameras. Komal, why is it important to think before you speak?
Avinis, ma'am, mic on.
Yes, hello. The people still don't have their cameras on. Toshi, are you finished?
Ma'am, 1 minute.
Okay. Fine. Uttam, are you there in the class? Everybody, please be prepared with at least one quote you want to speak about today for 2 minutes. About the 7 rules of communication. And if you do not have those quotes, I can recap again for you. But then you need to speak something about effective communication and what are the rules that you should imply. You can raise your hands, those of you who would like to speak. Komal, I'm still giving you time, prepare on it. Yes, Uttam. Akshay Kumar, put your camera on. Yes, what would you like to speak about?
I want to speak on a body language in a seven golden rule of effective communication.
And why is body language important in communication? Or how much weightage will you give to body language in communication?
Ma'am, body language is a very important part of communication because as it carries more than 55% of the communication. As body language support, it can support what we are trying to say or what we are trying to communicate with other. Our body language tell them before we speak that do we really support what we are going to speak or what we are speaking to anyone. The body language includes the eye contact, the posture, the way in which we are standing or in the way, in the manner we are sitting, our eye contact, our the entire part is dependent on body language. So I think body language is very important. We have to focus more on body language. It is a feature which say a lot of things without expressing any words. So this is very important in the communication.
Okay, body language. You listen to a lot of things which you said. And through body language, you get the non-verbal clues also. Why the person is saying, what are his expressions. So it is a type of non-verbal communication. It is communicating to you. It involves all physical behavior. Yes, Toshi, can we get back to you? One last question, Uttam. How will you understand body language?
Yes.
What is the process of understanding body language?
Ma'am, we can understand body language by observing the people with whom we are communicating. Like if we are communicating with a friend in the classroom, we can easily see where he is focusing. Is he looking at me or not? Is he interested in listening what I am trying to speak or not? Or he's reacting likewise in what way we are supposed to? And that are the ways we can absorb or identify a good body language or a bad body language.
So in body language, there is also positive and negative body language. The positivity and negativity involved in body language. Supposing somebody is sitting with a folded hands, it means that the person is not really interested in whatever you are speaking about. Or if his hands are at the back. So positive body language supports your points. It gives you an edge, helps you convey ideas more clearly and avoids sending mixed messages. You are not, the messages sent will not be mixed. So to understand verbal and non-verbal messages, you need to be very observant. You need to look at the person who's talking to, eye contact here is very important. Look at the person who is speaking to you for all kinds of non-verbal and verbal cues. Yes, Toshi, are you done with?
Yes, ma'am.
It can be an open posture, it can be a closed posture, it can be a limp handshake or a strong handshake. Yes, Toshi, continue.
Ma'am, as there were 7 points which we have learned, which you have to keep in mind before any communication. And in those points, there is a point on the mistake where we have heard a quote that is, apologizing is wonderful art, practice it. If we had made any mistake, then we have to apologize immediately, because it helped to build relationship with people you have hurt. That could be your colleague, client, friend, or family, anyone. If you had done any mistake, you have to own it quickly. Sometimes apologizing is difficult because we feel shame while apologizing, but if we apologize, it will make the situation better, not worse. Apologizing can help us to act better in future, maintain our self-respect also in eyes of others. Sometimes we apologize and our apology is not accepted right away. But still, we have to think that we had tried and we had apologized for whatever mistake we had done. And I would say that if you had done any mistake, try to apologize instead of feeling ashamed.
So basically, the apologizing itself contains two key elements. One shows your remorse. You feel remorse over your actions. It means you think over your actions. You feel guilty about it. If you feel guilty about it, only then you'll apologize. So
yes,
the first was one was you have to first, if you want others to forgive you, you first forgive yourself. So in apologizing, there are two elements. First is, it shows you feel remorse over your actions. And secondly, it acknowledges the hurt that your actions have caused. If you understand this, if you're observant, if you know that your words have caused hurt to someone, apologizing acknowledges the hurt that your actions caused to someone else. So in communication skills, what is the need of apologizing, Toshi?
Ma'am,
and how is it going to help you? How is it going to help interpersonal communication?
Ma'am, because if we had done any mistake, then the one who is hurted from me will not communicate with me. And when I apologize for my mistake, it will help in building good relationship with that person who is hurt. I think this, by this, it will help me in building interpersonal skills.
And of course, apologizing can help you to behave in a better way. It teaches you. You learn from apologizing. So you've taken the first step of learning. Then you apologize. Okay, I'm sorry. I should not have said that. Then I'm teaching myself if I say this. Okay, next time I'm not.
That's what I was telling, that it helps in building good relations with others.
Yeah, it does help in building interpersonal communications and relationship.
Yes.
So,
yes,
in apologizing, you own up your mistakes and you are on your way to become a good person. Not a good person, but a great person. The person who owns up, the person who apologizes first, always takes the cake and eats it too. So, it is it's a wonderful art, and keep practicing apologizing. Right?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes, Komal, are you prepared now to speak?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, Komal.
In golden 7 golden rules, the first one is articulation of thoughts before you speak. If any situations came, the smart people know the situations where I speak in such a way that we handle in such a manner. So, and and
Yes, Komal.
That's all, ma'am.
Anybody else? Akshay Kumar? Now, don't let me call you out by your names. Raise your hands, those who want to speak. Why is mutual respect important in communication? Tell me, what is mutual respect and how does it help? How will you bring humanity in your workplace? Bringing humanity, bringing goodwill in your workplace. So what is actually mutual respect? Hello, Akshay Kumar.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, please tell me, what is respect? And why should you respect people at work?
Ma'am, respect is a type of personal behavior. It connects the people in communication. And it helps to denotes the attitude of any person. And
so, Akshay, if I say that respect is a foundation of humane and ethical behavior, humane, kindness, a kind person,
yes,
should always be respectful, right? So if I tell you,
yes,
that respect is the foundation of humane and ethical behavior, and mutual respect, we are all talking about good relationships.
Yes.
To respect a person or to have respect for a person involves a fundamental belief in their rights to exist, to be heard, and to have the same opportunities as everyone else. So why respect, the function of respect in today's work ethics? Okay, tell me one thing. Why does mutual respect matter? Somebody else answer this question? Uttam Kumar? Saksham Rajput? Anybody else raise your hands? This is a really quiet class. Yeah, we're talking about mutual respect.
Mutual respect is very important.
Like how?
Yes, ma'am.
Mutual respect is very important because if we do not respect the person with which we are communicating, we are not supposed to be serious to us. If we are very clearly to listen much.
Uttam, you are not audible at all.
Hello.
Yes.
Am I audible?
Yeah.
Hello.
Continue.
I'm saying that mutual respect is very important because if we do not respect the person with we are communicating, then we do not expect that the person is interested in listening or can give more value to what we are trying to speak, or he also do not try to give answers to our question very seriously, because it takes the entire thing very lightly and the conversation is not going to be so serious.
Okay. Then you're talking about improved well-being, isn't it? Mutual respect, yes, all about improved well-being. You feel good, you feel being at a place, and it also includes a lot of other things. The first you're talking about is improved well-being and a more positive and focused working atmosphere. It relates to trusted and open communication. You trust people with mutual respect. You enter a trusted and open communication. And collaborative decision making. Better creativity, problem solving, and innovation. So all these things are involved in mutual respect. And increased loyalty among staff, leading to better retention of valued people, a reputation for fairness and ethical strength. So a lot of factors are involved and why it does matter. So all these topics given is going to take you ahead, prepare you for your job, why it is necessary to respect people. Uttam has spoken for the next time, and in class participation, every time you speak, you are graded, you are marked. CP counts a great deal in moving you ahead. There are other people in the class who have not spoken at all. Yes? Raise your hands. Sakshambrit Rajput, are you there in the class? Neha Kumari? Harsh Raj, Saksham, you're there in the class? Aman Srivastav? Yes, Aman. Yeah, switch on your camera, Aman. Hello. Okay, Aman is having network issues. When you come to the class, you come prepared. Because the communicative English classes are all there to give you a platform to speak. Okay, I'm sharing the screen with you. If nobody is speaking. Okay. For those who did not speak today, the quotes will, I'm revising it again for you so that you can take down as much. And Toshi, if you've spoken about one, try to speak about all the points given. And Komal, pay attention. So again, we are recapping it. Articulation of thoughts, think before you speak. This is the first, this was the first golden rule. A smart person knows what to say. A wise person knows whether to say it or not. So true communication goes beyond just speaking. Effective communication rules are imperative for success. Put verbal and non-verbal put together. So think before you speak. Talk for a minute. Talk for 2 minutes on. Think before you speak. And as, how will you explain this? A smart person knows what to say. A wise person knows whether to say it or not. So I believe everybody is wise in this class. Nobody is saying anything at all, right? The second. there were some incidents about persons talking about without thinking. The second was listening. Listening skills are indeed very important. The biggest communication problem is we do not listen to understand. We listen to reply only. Right now I'm recapping it again. People are not understanding this. And the biggest problem is that we do not listen to understand. Only we listen to reply, which should not be. Akshay, are you listening? So why is listening important? I might ask you this question again to you, Akshay. Why is listening important? Listening, to be a good speaker, be a good listener. Listening is very important. If I want people to listen to me, first I would like to listen to what others are saying. The importance of good listening can't be ignored. Ironically, the majority of us lack in this respect. To communicate clearly, it is important, it is imperative to listen attentively. Like, had you listened in the last class, you would have made a presentation. So, and there's a difference between listening and hearing. You may be hearing my voice is coming to you, but are you really actually listening? Are you attentive? Are you receptive? Are you receiving what you're listening? To develop the art of good listening, we sometimes need to clarify things. And the speaker has said, we all need to be aware of body language and to also empathize with the speaker. Think about the speaker. Be audience focused. Unnecessary arguments on the road, at the office, or at home can be avoided if a conscious effort is made to improve listening skills. So the question for you is, why is listening important? What is listening skill? And why is it important? The importance of listening skills at a workplace. Third, we spoke about body language and why body language is so important. Words and body language. If somebody is speaking, you listen to the words. But are you aware of his body language? The way he is talking, the way he is sitting. What are the expressions on his face? What is the tone in his voice? What is tone? Is the tone friendly? Is the tone angry? Is the tone soft? A person's actions will tell you everything you need to know. It means we'll reveal all the secrets. We'll tell everything. We'll spill out all the beans. We'll reveal everything you did not want to say, but your actions has said it all. Body language refers to speaking without words. It is about the gestures, the expressions that we should know when it comes to communicating with others, with other cultures. Experts say only 30% of communication happens through talking. Expressions and gestures matter a lot. In different cultures, the same action can have different meanings. For example, a firm handshake is expected in North America, but people in France prefer a gentle and small handshake. Fourth was empathize with others. Be considerate of the others. In the seven C's of communication, one C was consideration for others. Think about others. Think about what others will feel. How others will feel if I say this. Put yourself in somebody else's shoes and then think. Empathy is seeing with the eyes of another, listening with the ears of another, and feeling with the heart of another. Empathize with others. be considerate of others' feelings. Be a people person. If I'm saying be a people person, I'm meaning be considerate, empathize with other people, have sympathy for other people. The success rate of your communication will increase if you start empathizing with others. Try to understand others' viewpoints, especially when you do not agree with them. By empathizing, we try to move towards resolution and effective communication as well. Respect for others, mutual respect. What is mutual respect? What are the elements involved in respect? Why should we respect people? Different people have different opinions, and it's okay to respect them all. Different people have different opinions, and it's okay to respect all of them. So these quotes are so powerful. Do unto others as you would have done unto you. Behave in such a way, the way you want others to behave with you. Behave with the person in the same way. Like how you want to be treated, treat others in the same way. And a simple guideline to communication is successful. A simple guideline for a communication to be successful is respect. Not having a solid command of language or even lack of fancy words does not show that a person is inferior. Simultaneously thinking that we are always right and others always wrong showcases disrespect. We need to give equal importance to others' opinions, ideas. Doubting their caliber only leads to psychological barrier, which hinders the effectiveness of communication skills. 6, Toshi spoke about it. Own your mistakes. Forgiveness is a difficult process, but it's easier if you forgive yourself first. So apologizing is a wonderful art. Practice it. Very well spoken, Toshi. Accept your mistakes. Own your mistakes. You're not going to lose anything, but you're going to gain a lot by apologizing. And last is a positive attitude. You can't always have a good day, but you can always face a bad day with a good attitude. All days are not the same. Some are good, some are bad. Right now we are into this vulnerable condition about this, when we talk about the present scenario of COVID-19. No matter what, we just need to have a positive attitude. Positivity will show the way to success. Success, if you think negatively, negativity manifests. If you think nothing is going to be right, it manifests. Your feeling manifests. Okay, nothing is going to be right. Okay, fine. Then nothing will be right. If you tell yourself 10 times, I'm not feeling good, I'm not feeling well, I'm not feeling well, I'm not feeling well, you certainly would start feeling sick. But even if a sick person starts saying, everything is good, I'm fine, I'm okay, I don't have any problems, this very feeling manifests. It means it takes forms. Whatever you feel, whatever you say, whatever you think, takes shape. Success doesn't favor people based on education, experience, age, or any other physical trait. Success favors people who have positive attitude. Success at anything, including effective communication skills, can be achieved by maintaining a positive attitude. So this was the topic which I gave you for making a presentation. And I believe I have given you the questions and the answers. And you need to speak in this class. Some people have spoken. But then you need to speak. All of you need to speak. So Akshay, will you tell me When are you going to make a presentation?
On which topic?